Welcome back to the UBC, and what a final we have. Event 3 has pulled out all the tricks. The North Queensland Roos bowing out to an informed Warilla Gorillas in the first semi. Then the home team heroes took centre stage, but came up short with Exodas taking the win in semi-final two.
And this is how we got here. So Warilla got a straight pass through to the quarterfinals after being top two in their section. They took down the Wellington Hornets. They accounted for the North Queensland Roos in a quality semi-final. And then they got through to their final. And for Exodas, again, they got to bypass the preliminaries for the third event in a row. But this time they weren't going to be knocked out straight away. They took out the NCE Raptors convincingly 74-28. And then one of the matches of the UBC getting over the line against Dandenong Club to get into their first final. And they set up a heavyweight encounter, really, Greeny. I mean, these are some of the biggest names in lawn bowls about to do battle.
Yeah, well, you look if you look at the ultimate team, which will be announced later on, it looks like it's going to go the way of Warilla. They're in this final. And then you've got the team like Exodas, who have topped their sectional play games rounds each three events. So they've clearly been the best consistent team throughout the event. And then you've got Rilla in the finals, who's been the most consistent. So yep. Anything's going to happen here.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, from a footy point of view, it's almost like Port Adelaide back in the early 2000s. They kept getting minor premierships but couldn't make a grand final. But when they did in 2004, they got their very first premiership. And it's got those little shades about it. They just needed to get there. Exodus, and then you sort of feel like now that they are, the moment could be theirs.
Yeah, I sort of feel that a little bit as well, and the fact that they've just played and Warilla have had to sit a game off and come back on, and I think as well probably just that Bausi up front, fantastic. He will go hammer and tongs with Corey Wedlock. It'll be a great battle up front, and then it'll just see what happens with the skippers, and maybe just that slight nod towards Aron Sherriff because of just coming off the green. And also I think Aron Teys just wasn't quite at his best in the semi, but I don't know, he just has a knack of playing amazing in finals. So maybe a draw.
Yeah, they're all big game players, aren't they?
yeah.
And it looks like we are set to introduce our final sides. Let's start, Greeny, with the Warilla Gorillas.
Star outfit Aron Teys, he will be skipping this lineup, and none other than Corey Wedlock with his Wedlock weight, providing the goods up front for Warilla Bowls. Jeremy the King Henry, he'll be on the sideline, a little bit nervous, but he'll be cheering his boys on. Corey Wedlock, Aron Teys, and Jeremy Henry, Warilla Gorillas.
And they stick with the lineup that got them the title in UBC Event 2 this week. And if we're going to call a game a grand final matchup, we need a man that's won a grand final matchup. in this UBC event. We welcome Ray Pierce back. Razor, we'll get to you in just a moment, but there are your UBC, there are your Warilla Gorillas, the second final they've been in, event two winners, and they will take on this Exodas team that comes in after one of the most tightly contested semis we've seen. Talk us through this Exodas lineup.
Yeah, very impressive, as we know. Aron Sherriff is the boss, and he's going to be boss on this rink. Matty Baus, New South Wales junior and open singles winner. And Sean Ingham, Queensland State representative. There's a lot of star power in this. I don't think we'll change the lineup. So it'll be Matty Baus, Aron Sherriff, and Sean Nug Ingham. He'll be on the sideline cheering on Team Exodas.
And they stick with the semi-final winning matchup. Matty Baus the lead, Aron Sherriff the skip. One of the most decorated players in bowls history is Aron Sherriff. There is a lot of international experience out there between he, Corey Wedlock and Aron Teys. Ray Pierce being good enough to jump back in from the Geelong Clippers. Ray, this is a really tight one to call, but wow, what a lineup these two teams bring out.
Not just this lineup. I think the whole finals tonight has been that has been absolutely unbelievable. But to come down to these two teams for the final event, Exodas been most consistent, finishing on top of their section through the regular rounds, and Warilla already claiming a title. The two skippers are unbelievable too. So this should be a clanger.
Hey, I told you about the ultimate team earlier too.
What's that, brother?
That you didn't have a chance.
No, you're right.
You knew what was coming. Welcome back to commentary, Ray. And here's a backhander for good measure.
You knew what was coming. Can you give me the lotto numbers for tomorrow?
So, Razor, just as we see Corey Wedlock get things underway with his first in this first end of the final, have you got a tip?
I'm going a draw and an ultimate end to finish it off.
Well, how good would that be?
Then who wins the tiebreaker?
Good question.
Well, whoever's got the last bowl.
So in the event of a tiebreaker, Green, you just talk us through how that unfolds.
Yeah, so it's only the two players from each team that are on the rink, and instead of using three bowls each, they use one bowl each, and they just draw to the jack. It's the same where the mat and jack normally is, so 26 metres. And there's no points. It's simply whoever has the closest bowl after the four. It's nice and simple and easy. You're the champs.
Yes, Corey Wedlock straight away with a touch-up, and then blocking the jack from line of sight. That's how it's done.
Perfect start. Perfect start for the Gorillas. Front noser.
Kelsey Cotra was just talking about how she's been hearing a lot of people talking.
Oh, look at this.
Through.
Great shot.
Oh, that's a great response, Matt Baus. Got a thumbs up from Aron Sherriff because he doesn't get the toucher, but he puts them back in posse 1A. A lot of people, Kelsey was telling us, have just been in amazement at the consistency of this man on screen.
Yeah, well, I've had a lot to do with Corey Wedlock over the years, and he's been super impressive, even as a junior coming through. He played against his teammate, Aron Teys, for a long while there. And Corey and I played a lot of games together at Cabramatta Bowls Club, and he's been, look at this, I mean, he's...
He just switches hands and draws a toucher.
It's probably just his weight control. It doesn't matter what shot he's playing, but his weight control is absolutely sublime. And I'll tell you what, his opposition, though, Matty Baus, he's one of the best leads I've ever seen as well. Played a fair few games with the New South Wales side with Matty Baus, and absolutely very impressive.
And just at the moment, it looks like in Australian bowls, we're almost sport for choice with those leads. You know, you've got in the Jackaroos, Barry Lester, Wayne Rudiger, among a few.
Yeah, well, the boys and the girls head over to the UK soon for a selection camp, and it's going to be very interesting to see what the side looks like. Most of the other countries have named their teams, and Australia will be one of the last to name their team to head abroad.
So a 9-0 early lead to Warilla. They got the two touches courtesy of Corey Wedlock, but they got the crossover lead as well. Aron Teys first up. Now Aron Sherriff. A couple of Arons going head to head.
Probably the two best conversion players going head-to-head currently. It's quite exciting.
Now, just for the Arons out there, Aron Sherriff is a single A Aron, whereas Aron Teys is a double A. He's an Aron.
Aron?
And Aron Sherriff is an Aron.
Yeah, as his name's easy to remember. Oh, Sherriff, I shouldn't say as. It's, hard. It's 1A, and then his last name's double R, double F.
Here he is, three-time Bowls Australia International Bowler of the Year, world champion in the fours in 2014, Mark Casey, Wayne Rudiger.
Oh, what a shot. It's gone too far.
No, that's close. That's a 50-50 proposition on who's got first shot at the minute.
Corey favours his own.
The beauty about where these guys finished in sectional plays allowed them, so as soon as they've got in to the finals, they've got the same, like the bowls, like they're up the opposite ends.
Yeah.
So orange bowls, the last game they played, Exodus orange bowls, Warilla blue bowls.
Bit of a chill.
Teys.
Standing right over this is Corey Wedlock. It's just going to pull up.
Chance here for Omar. What's Baus looking for? So the ultimate team will be announced at the conclusion and the presentations, but I'm guessing Warilla.
Well, I thought it was going to come down to this match, Greeny.
Oh, really?
I have been wrong before.
Look at that
shot.
Aron Sherriff just makes a statement to finish out the first end. Gets a toucher. And gets him into that first shot position and third shot, so 16-14.
You could be right.
No, I'm pretty sure. Because after our conversation a bit earlier, Greeny, you had me thinking a little bit.
No, well, you are right, because...
And plus, yeah, I did a bit of mathematics.
Warilla's 1 point in front of Exodus.
Yeah, coming down to this match.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I'm pretty sure, ladies and gentlemen...
So that would mean, sorry to interrupt, Razor, but from a financial point of view, you're looking at $40,000 on the line in this match to win it and an extra $8,500 to be the ultimate team.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
So this game has just become an almost $50,000 game.
I think it's a perfect way to finish the week.
Couldn't have put it any better.
Yeah.
So that adds just another little layer.
Shot.
$48,500 up for grabs in this matchup. As we start the second end, 2 points separating. Both these leads are right on the money early. And a toucher for Matty Baus. Might just still have Warilla in lead shot, but they extend the lead to five.
So, Sam, what's going to actually happen is there'll be a count back if Exodus win. So that's going to have to be the management committee. I think it might come back to finals, potentially. Grand finals played.
Yep.
Okay.
Wow.
Oh, the response from Corey Wedlock.
Wow.
They trade blows early.
But anyway, we'll let Case worry about that.
That's above our pay grade.
We'll just focus on these touches because it's going to be some display of bowls.
Lead back to two. Matt Baus is running this in. Oh, he's knocked both away. So they've still got second shot and a two-point lead Exodus. But at the moment, Warilla would be back in the lead with the lead shot.
Oh, he's got the trot on,
the
Corey.
Crossover. Can he get an extra 6 points here with a toucher and lead?
Not quite there, but it's three handy bowls, though.
Yep.
That's a fair head.
So back in front. Or actually in front, I should say. They got out after two touches and a lead at the first end, they led 9-0. And Sherriff just pulls away mid-delivery stride. Now he resettles. He conned the shot clock too because it stopped.
He's looking pretty good here.
Oh, they're cheering this in.
Touch up.
Oh, wow. So close.
As you can see on screen there, that's the jack, and it is right amongst all the bowls. From the back camera view, you can only see the blue arrow bowl of Wedlock.
Aron Teys. Kelsey Cottrell said that she thought he might have been a little quiet in the semi, expecting him to have a big final.
Jesus, if he was quiet in the semi.
Well, that's what she said. She goes, he's still, no, but she said he was still unbelievable.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
She feels.
Has another level.
Well, yeah, I probably undersold that. Her view was that he has another level to go to in the big games.
Yeah,
that's what she was predicting.
Very cool.
I probably threw under the bus a bit there, didn't I, Greeny, to
no,
be fair?
No, not at all.
I don't think
all.
I adequately not reiterated.
Not at all.
Yeah, it wasn't like she said.
No, yeah, no, I'm with you.
Anyway,
yeah,
no. She said, she said he was useless.
Yeah. No,
no, she didn't. I promise you she didn't.
No, definitely not.
All right.
Jeremy hasn't moved from over there, like, literally all night.
He's been pacing, though, the big fella. He's been pacing, yeah.
I'll have to check if his son won any awards today, because every time his son's been winning awards, he wins the UBC. Happened a couple of nights ago.
Oh, he's got to get down a little bit here, get a double flick.
Yep.
Just a slight movement on the jack.
Might have just
as well
helped out Warilla. There's very little separating. Have a look at that grouping.
Well, the thing is now too, Razy, potentially you can draw down and get a toucher.
Oh, for an ultimate. Yeah, for an ultimate. Beforehand, you reckon? You reckon he'll go the back? Yeah, he's playing forehand.
So here we go. Tense moment at the end of the second.
We'll see how hard he's trying with it.
Can they bring up an ultimate end? This would really throw the cat amongst the pigeons.
He said he wasn't trying too hard, I don't think.
They'll be happy with first and third.
Yeah, good pickup.
And we'll go to an 11 point. In fact, it's a 9 point lead. So they got second shot Exodus, so they continue to get points. But that's a good end for Rawilla. 19 points in it. 8 points going the way of Exodus. 9 point Gorilla lead.
Another good start by Corey.
Harley McDonald, who's been your lead, Ray, has really impressed a lot. But how impressive is this young bloke being, Matt Baus?
Oh, look, Baus is he's been around for a long, long time down the Newcastle area there in New South Wales. And, he can match it with anyone, absolutely.
A touch-up to get things going and cut the margin back to just 6.
Yeah, add another one there for Corey.
Oh.
Always going head to head.
They did this in the last end. Touch answered with a touch.
I love the pace of the game too, Chrissy. I really love the pace of the game. It's gone really quick. Boys are in their groove, just getting on with it. Oh, that's a handy one out there for Bowsy.
Yeah, it's a quick format already, and with these four on the rink.
Yeah, no, it's good to watch.
I reckon the pace has been a lot quicker on day 3 than it was for.
Yeah.
First and second days. Wedlock coming after this on the trot.
Unbelievable.
And a touch-up.
Unbelievable.
He's two touches in a row for Corey Wedlock.
He's opened it up a little bit, but you'll take the 3 points. Bowsy will just up and about here, 6 feet away, trying to sit the bowl trailer jack, trying to get the 6 points.
Biggest lead of the game.
And he is all over it.
This is some display.
Wow.
This is some display. Elite level. To give them the lead shot and the toucher, and they are in first and second shot and trail by just 6.
We've seen it so often with the third bowl from the lead who goes second. If they are down to be playing some sort of weight. Look at this.
Great shot. Great conversion.
There was a touch-up.
Yeah, he really had to get it out there with his first bowl. Mm.
5 touches already in this third end.
Problem is he's got Aron Sherriff coming in underneath him with plenty of room. So it was a rare miss there by Omar. Bit of an opportunity here to apply the pressure back on, especially with a 9-point lead already. He's chasing it too, he likes it. It's just a matter of how close he can get to it. Well, it's a good shot, there's 2 really good bowls there from Teesy.
He's giving him first.
Just a little bit of room for Omar. It's just a matter of, it's in a bit of a tricky spot trying to clear his front one and get underneath Aaron's ball. So he's going to come underneath everything. He's just dropped short again there, so.
So there'll be a final chance for Aron Teys to pick up some more points here, because at the moment they've got first, but second and third going to Exodus, so it'll be 8 points to them.
Well, I dare say he'll definitely get third. It's just a matter of
Aron Sherriff with one to come after this.
Pace looks okay.
He needs to clear the front orange.
Oh, no, he might have helped him out.
All right, so boys, there's a bit of an opportunity here for Omar to get the bowl out for three.
Yeah.
I think it's a better shot than trying to draw the shot, especially with the traffic in the road. He might just go for this for an ultimate end here.
So you're trying to, you're saying put some heat on this?
I dare say it'd be a nice solid shot. Try and get the bowl out. And if it's a bonus, he gets the inside of the bowl for a touch or two.
That's what he's playing, Razor.
Here he comes. Aron Sherriff
needs it to move.
Whoa. Wow. Wow.
So it's very, very tight. Warilla will go to 62 points.
They beat you to it.
I've already put that score on the board. Wow. How good. How good are the team in the
track? I'll tell you what, Maxi the Mark, he's been unreal.
Yeah.
He has been unreal this week. Actually, all the volunteers have, to be honest.
Point Warilla lead. They've gone 19 point ends the last two. It was a 17 point end for Exodus.
Yeah, so you look at the 11 points, but 11 points is not much at all.
No, exactly.
It is not much at all, especially with the caliber that's out on the rink at the moment.
Yeah, there's plenty of scoring power with these players, and it's right from the start. Said you could be 11 up and then potentially you could be down at the crossover, three touches and the
crossover, yeah, three touches, yeah, exactly. Oh, a couple of loose ones from Corey there, you won't be happy with that.
Don't think anyone said that the whole tournament, a couple of loose ones from Corey.
Yeah, no, true.
We haven't heard that.
Very true. It's been a very long week, but the boys have kept up the standard the whole week. Baus is two handy ones again.
Look at that. Oh,
but there is a lot of room there. It doesn't look like it on the screen, but when you put a bowl in Corey Wedlock's hands,
doesn't need much. It
doesn't need much at all. Just a matter of whether he's going to hold on here. But his weight's sublime. It's probably enough.
Great example of it. He can put one.
Here's Nug.
Good old Nug.
Third member of the team, Sean Ingham, Queensland representative.
Looks fresh.
Looks nervous. He's pacing over there.
Matt Baus is bringing this all the way in.
Baus is weight.
Oh, that's three
up.
Very well played bowls. Warilla going to get the lead shot though. So, gee, halfway through the penultimate end, a 14-point lead in a tight contest.
There's Big Jez, just nice and relaxed, you know.
He's cruising, isn't
he? He's holding the TV stand up for us.
There's no pressure on him at all. Love and life. Well, even though Warilla are holding the shot, I think the setup for Exodus is a hell of a lot better to score on this end.
Aron Teys, does he sneak this in? No.
It's probably third, close to third.
Yep. Aron Sherriff, get the feeling that this is set up for a Sherriff special to lay down the law.
There's plenty of opportunities here for him. He can get to the shot bowl here.
Good shot. That's enough to shot. Great shot.
Yep.
And great shot.
Just for equal measure, just to give yours a little step aside.
Teezy's weight wasn't too bad. He just got to bring a bowl inside and he can touch the jack.
He seems to like it.
Let's hit Omar's bowl. He just needs to hurry a fraction.
Oh, it just faded late, didn't it?
Oh, just a mild touch here for Omar, and this could turn into an 18-point end as it lies.
Wouldn't that be a thrilling way to turn for home?
100%, 100%. I think it deserves it too, to be honest with you.
The final.
Might flop off that one for another one, yep.
Of the third event.
So that'll be
Teys.
It looks
and
like
Aron Sherriff trading blows. You think that that's 1, 2, and 3 for Exodas?
Well, 1 and 2. I've got a bit of information here for you, Sam, about the Ultimate Team.
Yep, we'll get to that in just a moment. We'll just see this be sent down by Aron Teys because it feels like a crucial part of...
He's underneath.
It needs to hurry. Crucial point in time. Oh. That's going to fade on him.
Can he work off that?
Doesn't quite nestle in. It might be good for second. In fact, it'll still be pretty close, I reckon. We have a closer look at that.
We're going to be real close after the completion of this end if it stays this way.
So they're 14 points adrift at the moment on the scoreboard. Can Aron Sherriff bring up an ultimate end to catapult them back into the lead with an end to play?
Just going a bit. Flop back in. So it looks like orange, blue, orange.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the final end of our final match for this week here at the Dandenong Club.
Well, Warilla take the lead there, 60-54. Continue leading, sorry, into the last end. And that update, if Exodas win, then it's a draw and goes on count back. But Exodas wins the count back. If Warilla win, they win.
Yeah.
So the Exodas count back would be they've won more sectional games.
Okay.
So the consistency...
So basically whoever wins, wins.
Yes. So,
nice.
There is a count back.
Nice. I like it.
So $48,500 rests on this end.
Yep.
And it's just 6 points separating these two teams. What a way to finish off this UBC tournament, the Ultimate Bowls Championship. Three events. Each event spread out over 2 days. And we are down to the final end of the final final on the final day. A toucher straight away for Corey Wedlock. Some breathing space.
And also last bowl too. So with the Exodas winning the last end, Warilla have the last bowl for the last end for the title. And potentially the ultimate. Oh, Bousy's boy scored a toucher.
Bousy boy. The caliber, the caliber of bowls on display here is something else.
So the title, the ultimate's going to change bowl by bowl here.
It is. 6 point lead to Warilla.
And this might be one of those games where even if you do score 70, you're
not
safe.
Have a look at this. Wow.
Almost the toucher as well, but first and second shots to Warilla at the minute.
It's not a great setup though for the Gorillas. Not for someone like a Baus, he can reach up to here, sit a bowl, trailer jack. Yep. He's got this
right on target.
How far's it going?
Oh,
what a shot.
On the button.
Wow.
Matty Baus just lands one on the beak of the Gorillas. And they only trail by 3 points now. And if Corey Wedlock can't land this for lead shot, Exodas will draw level.
Is he high enough? Is he high?
Can he get a slide?
Yep.
Is he going to get it in? And he does.
He does. It's all about weight.
Corey Wedlock sneaks that through to give the Gorillas a 6 point lead with half an end to play.
$40,000 first place, $20,000 for the runner-up.
Wow.
Team honors up for grabs as well.
What a match. It's had it all, and...
Is he going for the bowling?
Three bowls each.
Is he going for the sit?
We're being treated here. Aron Sherriff
is
going aggressive.
Is he down enough?
Oh, what a shot.
Oh, yes.
What a shot.
That's a bully boy manoeuvre from Aron Sherriff. Send your packing.
It's crazy.
This game's just a highlight reel.
This is crazy. Going head-to-head here. How's he looking?
He's just got to hurry.
No, his speed's good. No, it's enough.
Oh, and the toucher as well.
All right.
Aron Teys answers back in a big way.
It's a big shot here. Jack High bowl for Omar. He's never, his eyes be lighting up here.
9-point lead.
Half bowl, Jack.
And the shot, Aron Sherriff charges this one down.
Is he holding?
Does he hold the line? Oh, yes, he got a touch up.
That's good.
And he still concedes first shot.
Wow.
Could we have asked for a better final, Ray Pearce?
No, no, we can't.
Just 6 points in it. At the moment, so Warilla have got one hand.
Teesy, he'd love another toucher here. He'd love another toucher here.
He'll have one more after this.
Even a third shot is pretty good. Third shot's good.
Yep, and that's what he'll give them.
Yep. All right, so he's got...
This is the final bowl for Aron Sherriff.
So he needs 372. He needs at least a shot, obviously, with a toucher or third shot.
Alex Marshall says that this man is the best in the world.
Well, coming it'll from take, the best in the world.
It'll take something.
How are we looking?
Best in the world. Just is underneath. It going to hold? It's just underneath.
Wow.
We've been thoroughly entertained. One of the matchups of the whole UBC comes to an end. A fitting final, and Warilla win the third final, their second in a row, to the applause of the crowd at Club Dandenong. 82-68. That was just a pleasure to partake in, a pleasure to watch, a real treat. And Warilla not only win the third final, but they will win the ultimate team prize as well. So that performance will get this team $48,500.
That is a fitting way to finish. Absolutely unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable.
That was a lot of fun. Shot for shot, they went blow for blow. Anything you can do, I can do better. Yeah. It was a matchup, Ray Pearce, of one-upmanship of the highest order.
Yeah, no, exactly. The four players absolutely put on a clinic, and they played to their full ability, and the crowd was entertained. Happy days.
Yep, it was. That's how you want to cap off what's been a magnificent week at Club Dandenong. This UBC event, a couple of years off due to COVID, so well supported, so well put together. Some of the very best in the world have been here strutting their stuff. And for the second event in a row, the Warilla Gorillas are our final winners. An 82-68 victory in the end that could have gone either way, going right down to the wire. And a very happy Warilla outfit with our very own Chris Green.
Thanks very much, Sam. Jez, I'm going to ask you the first questions because I think these guys deserve a bit of a breather. Was that one of the best games you've ever seen?
Oh, it was outstanding, wasn't it? Four players all. I don't know how many touches it was for the game, but it was nerve-wracking on the sidelines.
I think in the final end, the winner changed about five or six times. It was almost like, as Sam just mentioned in the box, anything you can do, I can do better, and then vice versa. Teesy, very impressive with Corey's setup.
As I said, mate, it's just it's nice when he just keeps getting touches in the crossover. Just racks them 3 points up like it's Christmas.
And Corey, you must be pretty happy, mate. It's taken a while to get your first UBC victory and then 2 days to get your second.
Yeah, no, over the moon. I love playing with Teesy and Jez. I'll just try and get a few in the air, a few touches, and let Teesy do the rest. He played awesome all week. So, yeah, stoked to get one.
No, good job. And Teesy, I heard you're going to be dodging the ice buckets this afternoon.
Yeah, so after event one, obviously, Harley McDonald's one of my best mates. So I tipped the ice thing over his head and he got me back game two, so I'm dodging him.
No, well done, guys. Congratulations once again. We're going to get the presentation shortly. We'll let you just have a quick little breather and then we'll head up the other end. Back to you, Sam.
Thank you, Greeny. Well done to you and well done to the Warilla outfit. And after we were a little bit surprised, Ray Pearce, when Warilla were knocked out in the quarterfinals of the first event. But when they bounce back and they win the second event final, they win the third event final and the ultimate team, they're going to walk away with not far off $100,000 for their UBC event. That's great going between them, yourselves, at Geelong Clippers, who won the first event and came runner-up in the second. What a tournament.
Yeah, well, I think a big congratulations has to go out to all the franchises and all the supporters, you know, to be putting that kind of money up for an event and, you know, close to $500,000 throughout the whole week. We've never seen it before.
22 teams, almost $500,000 in prize money. And these were the highlights of the Warilla Gorillas getting it done in the third final. The Event 3 final, a culmination of a magnificent tournament. And I think by my count, and I could be wrong, because I was so engrossed in the action, I may have lost count. I think there were 14 touches in the final.
Unbelievable.
At least 13, I'm thinking maybe 14.
I could watch this highlight reel over and over and over again.
I don't know if we've got time. it's that full of just top-notch bowl after top-notch bowl.
The head turned over just about every single bowl throughout that match. Unbelievable to watch.
So they qualified top two in their section, Warilla, to bypass the prelims. They took down the Wellington Hornets in the quarterfinals. They survived another big scare from the North Queensland Roos, who knocked them out of the finals in event one. And then they played out an out-and-out thriller against the Exodas team, who did so earlier in their semi. I mean, we thought the Dandenong and Exodas semi...
That was unreal too.
...was going to be the match of event three, but...
100%.
...with all due respect to that one, this one was something special.
Not just that, they've played quality plays throughout that final series.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say it was convincing, like haven't been convincing games, but they were unbelievable for three games straight there. Unbelievable.
Yep. Yeah, they were. And when you look at the players who play, like the Hornets, 14-time New Zealand champion Gary Lawson, you've got a former Australian male bowler of the year in Dave Ferguson with the Hornets as well. And the list goes on and on. Every team with world-class players in amongst them. Wonderful performance from Warilla. Same too for Exodas. Let's get to Benny Jones with the official presentation.
Thanks very much, Sam. Well, what can we say? An incredible, a tremendous final, and what a great way to conclude this Ultimate Bowls Championship week right here at the Dandenong Club. We hope you've enjoyed the coverage at home as much as we've enjoyed the efforts of all of the players here at the venue. I want to thank our sponsors one final time. Audica, Specsavers, Apia Insurance, Ryman Healthcare, Sports Centre and Hensolite. Again, this event would not be possible without your incredible support, so thank you. Also want to take a moment, if I could, to give a special thanks to our amazing group of volunteers. They are literally the glue that holds events like these together. Long starts and early days, I should say, and obviously just being here day in, day out to make this all possible. It's just part of their job. So on behalf of the UBC committee and all of the players, we'd like to extend a massive thank you to our volunteers for their efforts. It doesn't go unnoticed. You can all go and have a well-earned drink. Go and put your hands together for the volunteers. We'll also acknowledge the staff here at the Dandenong Club for the last 6 days have put on one hell of a show and have also made sure the players are well looked after, well fed and well hydrated throughout. So thank you to the Dandenong Club. The fans in the stands as well, they have been incredible. Our owners and support crews who spur these athletes on to showcase their talents and produce their best day in, day out. Thank you as well for your unwavering support. So let's begin our Event 3 presentations. And we will begin by announcing the winner of the Golden Touch Award. Regular face up here for this particular award, now a two-time winner. Please congratulate Scott Thorborn from the Broadbeach Lions. Well done, Scott. Well, I think it's fair to say we definitely left the best until last. That final between the Warilla Gorillas and Exodas was something else. Could we please put our hands together for both finalists, as well as all of the teams that made it through to tonight's knockout finals. Let's start by congratulating our runners-up for this Event 3 of the Ultimate Bowls Week. And they will walk away with very nice medals, but also an even nicer cheque for $20,000. Put your hands together for Team Exodas. Representing Exodas, Aron Sherriff, Matt Baus, and Sean Ingham. Well done to Team Exodas on an amazing run in this event. But what about this team? Not content with winning in Event 2, they thought they'd double it up and add another $40,000 to their bank balance. They were brilliant throughout. Well done to the Warilla Gorillas, our Event 3 champions. Representing the Gorillas, Aron Teys, Corey Wedlock, and Jeremy Henry. And as the team spokesman, Jeremy, I'll get you again to say a few words.
Thank you. Well, firstly, I'd like to thank Mark Casey and the UBC for another fantastic event. I'd like to thank the Dandenong Bowling Club for all their volunteers, umpires, especially their bar staff, looked after us really well. I'd like to thank all the prize winners. It's been a long few days, but a very enjoyable few days. Who else would I thank? I'd like to thank Warilla Bowling Club for putting our team together and paying for us to play in this event. They look after us really well. I'd like to thank Philip Kipp and all the directors of the club. What else? I'd like to thank Exodas. He's been brilliant all week. I think you topped the sections all three times. Now he lost a couple of quarters and then got to the final. You're brilliant. What a fantastic game. Like, with touchers galore. And actually, I was watching the boys' event too, and I watched the way they played in the finals, and I'd a little tip to myself. I said, I'll play the first five games, get out of the way, and let them go. So that's what we've done for Event 3, so I'll take coaching for that. Thanks, everyone, and hope to see you all again in December. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeremy. Now, we'll get the guys to just hold up here for a moment, because this being the final event of the Ultimate Bowls Week here at the Dandenong Club, we have the pleasure of announcing the overall winner for the Ultimate Team Awards at these Ultimate Bowls Championships. Now, this is, of course, going to the team that secures the most points across the past three events. And to prove how close this was, much like the Event 3 final, this was decided on the very last bowl of the night. In third place, Event 1 winners and Event 2 runners-up, the Geelong Clippers. In second place, it was Exodas, But will you join me in congratulating, of course, the Warilla Gorillas, who are your ultimate team for this Ultimate Bowls Championships. For their efforts, an additional $8,500 goes their way, and some nice medals as well. So ladies and gentlemen, one more time, put it together for our Ultimate Bowls team for this week here at the Dandenong Club, the Warilla Gorillas, event 2 and 3 champions, and our ultimate team. They have just done superbly over the last 6 days. So that from us is pretty much a wrap. What a great week it's been. Thank you to everyone who has attended. We've loved seeing so many faces, familiar and new, to this event, and also the great camaraderie and obviously the great friendship played out on these rinks between the bowlers who have come from far and wide. We look forward to seeing you in December as we embark on the Moma Bowling Club for another huge week of UBC competition. And as we do sign off, we say one final time, congratulations to all winners, individual and team, throughout the week. It has been a hell of a lot of fun. And of course, well done again to the Warilla Gorillas, your Event 3 champions. Back to you, Sam.
Thank you, Benny. We'd also, before we say goodbye, I'd like to thank our valued sponsors. This event could not occur without you. Enjoy better hearing with Audica. If you're over 26, book your free hearing check today at audica.com.au. Love your ears. Should have gone to Specsavers. Keeping on top of your eye health is our turf. And today's game, just like every day's games, have been brought to you by Apia, Australia's go-to insurance for retirees. Apia, get set, go. And Ryman Healthcare, proud to partner with the UBC. Ryman have been creating vibrant retirement villages for over 35 years with passionate bowlers playing a big part in their community. So partnering with us was a natural fit. To learn more about the Ryman difference, visit rymanhealthcare.com.au. A big thank you to our sponsors. Thank you to all the volunteers. A big thanks to Club Dandenong for putting together this, putting together this magnificent venue to host this phenomenal event. It is a credit to you and your club. It's shown up and shown out beautifully. To all 22 teams who have participated in this event, a big thank you to you and every one of the players that made up those extraordinary teams. To our winners, the Geelong Clippers Event 1 winners, the Warilla Gorillas Events 2 and 3 winners, and the Ultimate Team winners, congratulations to you. To Mark Casey and the whole UBC team, to Chris Green, my partner in commentary, and all the players that rotated through the middle seat to cast their eye and give us their expertise, wonderful insights, and we greatly appreciate you taking the time out to help us through this broadcast. To the whole team that put the broadcast together, phenomenal job. Big thank you to you. Don't forget, the UBC draft is in October. All the details on the UBC website, www.ultimatebowls.com.au. The next UBC event, December 11th to 16th, Moama. So check the UBC website. Until then, we cannot wait to see you. That's it from us. We'll see you all again next time. Have a great night. Stay safe. The UBC is proudly supported by Ryman Healthcare, Hensolite, Sports Centre, Audica, Specsavers, Apia, and the Dandenong Club.